Good evening and welcome to St Luke's for our Ash Wednesday service. We hope and pray that this will be a special service for us all as we prepare to worship and prepare ourselves for our pilgrimage through Lent. And we pray, Lord, that you'll be with us as George preaches and begins our Lent course. Would you please stand? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, since early days Christians have observed with great devotion the time of our Lord's Passion and Resurrection, and prepared for this by a season of penitence and fasting. By careful keeping these days, Christians take to heart the call to repentance and the assurance of forgiveness proclaimed in the Gospel, and so grow in faith and in devotion to our Lord. You are invited to the observance of a holy Lent by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, and by reading and meditating on God's holy word. And so we're going to sing 40 days and 40 nights. Let us pray. Let us pray for grace to keep Lent faithfully. We say together, Holy God, our lives are laid open before you. Rescue us from the chaos of sin, and through the death of your Son, bring us healing and make us whole. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, The first commandment is this, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this, love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Let us call to mind our sin and the infinite mercy of God. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart God will not despise. Let us come to the Lord who is full of compassion and acknowledge our transgressions in penitence and faith. Let us return to the Lord our God and say to him together, Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be. That we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. The Lord enrich you with his grace and nourish you with his blessing. The Lord defend you in trouble and keep you from all evil. The Lord accept your prayers and absolve you from your offences. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. And the collect for today, Ash Wednesday. Almighty God and everlasting God, you hate nothing that you have made, and forgive the sins of all those who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may receive from you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Marie will now read our first lesson.
Our first reading this evening is taken from 2 Corinthians, chapter 5, verse 20, to chapter 6, verse 10. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake he made him to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, At an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, Now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labours, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God. With the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honour and dishonour, in ill repute and good repute, we are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet are well known, as dying, and see, we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We stand to sing, Dear Lord and Father of mankind.
Thank you.
Gospel reading. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. The Lord is a great God. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Harden not your hearts. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, "Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look dismal, like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Do please be seated, thank you. May the words of my lips and the thoughts of our hearts be now and always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. This evening's short address is an introduction to the Bible studies that we will be following through the season of Lent each Wednesday in the parish centre, and they're based on the prodigal son. The theme of the studies is discovering the heart of God. And in this introductory short address today, we remind ourselves that in Luke chapter 15, there's not just one parable, but three, and all of them point quite clearly to God and his plan and his purpose for our lives. The chapter begins with a rather derogatory statement. This man receives sinners and eats with them. The Pharisees were complaining about our Lord fraternizing with sinners. The context, of course, is clear. Here, the Pharisees are showing a judgmental attitude not only towards our Lord, but towards others as well. And isn't it always a sad thing when people feel that they need to judge others? Many hasty and misjudged assessments of character are made on the basis of our own fallen nature. The Pharisees, like ourselves, needed to learn that they too are sinners. They may sin in different ways to the tax collector or indeed the publican, but sinners they are. But however, our Lord did not come to condemn. He came to reveal the true attitude of God to fallen humanity. And this Jesus does as we look at the three parables today in Luke 15. The lost sheep, the lost silver, and the lost son. The last of the three we will be looking at in great depth during this Lenten season. But as we look at those three parables briefly, the first thing that we are faced with, and this will come up clearly in our studies during this Lenten time, is that we belong to God. Just as the sheep belonged to the shepherd, and just as the coin belonged to the woman, so in Jesus' day, the son belonged to the father and his household. We are reminded, if we need reminding, that we are created for God. We are created to live in fellowship with him. God made us for himself. And as Saint Augustine said many years ago, our souls are restless until they find their rest in God. The world of today says, I am my own man. I don't belong to anyone. I live for myself. No one owns me. And that can permeate into the heart of the Christian fellowship itself. But we are reminded as we approach this season of Lent that the Bible says that you and I have been bought with a price. St. Paul puts it like this, for you were bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body. And during our Lenten time, we will remind ourselves of what it cost our Lord to bring us back to himself, what it cost him so that we might enter into that fullness of life that he has for us. And how dearly did he pay that price on the cross of Calvary. And no one following Jesus can ever say, I am my own person. I don't belong to anyone. I live for myself. No one owns me. Because that's not what we were taught, and that is not what the scriptures say. We have indeed been bought with a price, the precious blood of Christ. But those three parables not only remind us that we belong to God, they also remind us that God loves us. Just as the shepherd searches for the lost sheep, just as the woman searches diligently for the lost coin, or just as the father yearns for the homecoming of his wayward son, so it is with the heart of God. It may be difficult for us to understand or even to accept the fact that God loves us just as we are. You and I don't need to achieve an ethical A level to receive the favor of God. One of the great errors that we find again and again within the Christian church is, I'm not good enough. But that's why you're here. That's why Christ died for us. And we may look at it like that, but that's not how God sees it. And as we look at the prodigal son, we will begin to unwrap this great truth. So, whether we are like the sheep who go astray, or whether people find themselves lost like the coin, or willfully expanding their wings like the prodigal, this matters little. We all come under the umbrella of God's love. But lastly, in this introductory talk, looking at chapter 15 of Luke and those three parables, we are reminded as well that God rejoices when we return to him. There is joy in the presence of the angels over one sinner who repents. This is how St. Luke puts it. Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. So just as the returning son brings unspeakable joy to the father, and just as finding the lost sheep returned to the fold brings great joy to the shepherd, just as finding the lost coin brings joy to the woman, so it is in the heart of God. You and I have the capacity to bring joy into the very realms of heaven itself. So to sum up this introductory talk, these three parables are pointing us in a certain direction. It's telling us that there are some people, maybe people like ourselves, or are people who never think about spiritual things, who need to find their rightful place in life. There are so many people who go about life day by day and never really feeling that they fit in. They're not happy with themselves. They're not happy with their bodies. They're just not happy. And we can see this today in displaying itself in so many, many different ways. A GP friend of mine some years ago said to me, he said, George, you know, my surgery is filled with people who think I have a pill for everything. That somehow I can dispense a pill and it will take away all their woes, all their depression. He says, the people that I don't find regularly in my study are people who are people of faith, because they have found their rightful place in life, and how important that is. Or we may look at that coin that was found, and we're reminded there are people and they need to discover their rightful purpose in life. The coin returned to the bracelet or the necklace or the headdress, wherever it came from, but it found its place its place, its rightful purpose, the purpose for which it was made and created and cherished. And for so many people today, and this is why our Lenten study will be very, very important, I think, that for so many people, they have lost the sense of meaning and purpose and direction in their lives. Like the coin, they need to find their rightful purpose. But then, of course, the one person that we will be homing in on, the prodigal himself, tells us that there are many, many people who need to find the right path in life. A right path which is a living and loving relationship with God the Father. There are many, many ways in which people today are lost, and their lostness expresses itself in different ways. But how profound is Luke chapter 15? Have you and I found our rightful place in life? The study will challenge us in that way. Have you and I found our rightful purpose in life? The study again will ask us to consider that. But perhaps above and beyond everything else, the study will bring us down to the nitty-gritty of what it's all about. The walk that we have in life. Is it a living, loving relationship with a God who loves us with an everlasting love? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. God's heart is a heart of love. It's a heart of love for you and for me. And he wants us to have nothing but the best that life can bring. He wants to lift us out of our lostness. He wants us to be found. And above all, to experience that fullness of life that faith in Christ alone can give. So I'm very glad that our Lord sat down with sinners, because it means that he sits down with me. And I'm so glad that in that, I too can discover the heart of God, which is a heart of love.
Full notes are on the website for those who are watching, and you can collect them as you leave church if you haven't managed to print them all. So, shall we stand together and declare our faith? Together we say, we believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Would you like to sit for prayer? Today, the Roman Catholic Church, the Pope, has called for a day of fasting and prayer for the people of Ukraine. And our prayers, led by Marie, are based on the prayers that have been sent round so that we can pray for that situation on this most holy day. Thank you, Marie.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. We pray for the leaders of the nations. We pray that you will guide them in the ways of freedom, justice, and truth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who bear arms on behalf of the nation, that they may have discipline and discernment, courage and compassion. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our enemies and those who wish us harm, that you will turn the hearts of all to kindness and to friendship. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the wounded and the captive, the grieving and the homeless, that in all their trials they may know your love and support. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear us, Lord, as we call to mind the people we know in our community who specifically need your healing touch. And we pray for Margaret Miller, Reverend Stephen Jackson, Anthony Staples, Josephine Brevett, Trevor Linford, Joe Parks, Cava, John and Phyllis Timmins, Teresa, Alan, Frank Gullett, and Jennifer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear us, O Lord, as we remember those who have died in the peace of Christ, both those who have confessed the faith and those whose faith is known to you alone. And we especially pray for Rita Flynn, Graham Morris, Alan Shaw, and Sue Parker. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Most holy God and Father, hear our prayer for all who strive for peace and all who fight for justice. Help us, who today remember the cost of war, to work for a better tomorrow. And as we commend to you lives lost in terror and conflict, bring us all, in the end, to the peace of your presence, through Christ our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy, fill us with your Spirit. Hear our prayer, and make us one in heart and mind, to serve you with joy forever. Amen.
Would you like to stand for the peace? Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Pour upon the poverty of our love and the weakness of our praise the transforming fire of your presence.
Amen.
Amen.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
You are worthy of our thanks and praise, Lord, of God of truth, for by the breath of your mouth you have spoken your word, and all things have come into being. You fashioned us in your image and placed us in the garden of your delight. Though we chose the path of rebellion, you would not abandon your own. Again and again you drew us into your covenant of grace. You gave your people the law and taught us by your prophets to look for your reign of justice, mercy, and peace. As we watch for the signs of your kingdom on earth, we echo the songs of the angels in heaven evermore, praising you and singing.
Thank you.
God, you are the most holy one, enthroned in splendour and light. Yet, in the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, you reveal the power of your love, made perfect in our human weakness. Amen. Lord, we believe. Embracing our humanity, Jesus showed us the way of salvation, loving us to the end. He gave himself to death for us, dying for his own. He set us free from the bonds of sin, that we might rise and reign with him in glory. Amen. Lord, we believe. On the night he gave up himself for us all, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Amen. Lord, we believe. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Amen. Lord, we believe. Therefore, we proclaim the death that he suffered on the cross. We celebrate his resurrection, his bursting from the tomb. We rejoice that he reigns at your right hand on high, and we long for his coming in glory. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. As we recall the one perfect sacrifice of our redemption, Father, by your Holy Spirit, let these gifts of your creation be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Form us into the likeness of Christ and make us a perfect offering in your sight. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Look with favour on your people, and in your mercy hear the cry of our hearts. Bless the earth, heal the sick, let the oppressed go free, and fill your church with power from on high. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Gather your people from the ends of the earth to feast with all your saints at the table in your kingdom, where the new creation is brought to perfection in Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Thank you.
those of you who will be unable to join us at the table, we say, Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your disciples, I am with you always. Be with me today as I offer myself to you. Hear my prayers for others and for myself, and keep me in your care. Amen. O God, help me to trust you. Help me to know that you are with me. Help me to believe that nothing can separate me from your love revealed in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
So we come to our post-communion prayer. Almighty God, who hast given thine only Son to be unto us both a sacrifice for sin and also an example of godly life, give us grace that we may always most thankfully receive that his inestimable benefit, and also daily endeavour ourselves to follow the blessed steps of his most holy life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we say together, God of our pilgrimage, you have fed us with the bread of heaven. Refresh and sustain us as we go forward on our journey. In the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son. He is the sacrifice for our sins, that we might live through him. If God loves us so much, we ought to love one another. If we love one another, God lives in us. Please stand to sing Love Divine or Love's Excel.
Thank you.
Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and those whom you love, now and always. Amen. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.